Good morning. In today's class, we are going to continue with the conversion part of decimal system. So here I am going to teach you about how to convert a decimal to hexadecimal, vice versa, then octal to decimal and vice versa, then conversion between binary to hexadecimal, hexadecimal to binary, then binary to octal, then octal to hexadecimal, and so on. So let us start with an example how to convert a hexadecimal number into decimal. So let us take an example. The given hexadecimal number is 837E.5C2. So this is a hexadecimal number. You need to convert this into decimal. So as we have seen for the binary to decimal conversion, you need to identify the weightage. That is, for the binary it is 2 power of 0, 2 power of 1, 2 power of 2, and so on. And for the fractional part, from the right hand side you need to start. That is 2 power of minus 1, 2 power of minus 2, 2 power of minus 3. In the same way, here also you need to make the conversion. That is, here instead of 2 you have to consider 16. So for the integer part, A37E, start from the LSB, the weightage is 16 power of 0, the next bit at a 16 power of 1, then 16 power of 2, 16 power of 3. So identify the weightage and multiply with the given hexadecimal number and add it, will be getting the value as 41,854. And similarly for the fractional part, as I told, the weightage is it will be in negative, and you need to start from the right hand side. The weightage is 16 power of minus 1, 16 power of minus 2, 16 power of minus 3. So multiply the corresponding weightage with the given hexadecimal number and add it, you'll be getting the decimal fraction as 0.35986, and together you can represent the decimal value as 41,854.35986 base 10. Again, down I have represented together as a single step. Identify the weightages and multiply with the corresponding hexadecimal number, and together you can represent the decimal number as 41,854.35986. So now it is the reverse, that is converting a given decimal number to hexadecimal number. So whatever the given decimal number, for the hexadecimal conversion you have to divide by 16. So the same procedure we have followed for conversion from decimal to binary also. For binary we have divided by 2, whereas for hexadecimal you have to divide by 16. So I have taken the given decimal number, the integer part, I am dividing by 16. Parallelly I am recording the remainders also. Again, that remainder I am representing in terms of hexadecimal values, that is from 0 to F. So whatever the given integer part, 10,767, I'll keep dividing by 16 until I am getting a quotient which is less than 16. Till that you need to divide it. So divide 10,767 by 16, you are getting us 672, and the remainder is 15. Immediately convert that remainder into hexadecimal, which is 5. Again, you divide 672 by 16, you will be getting a quotient as 42, whereas the remainder is 0. Again, divide 42 by 16, that is quotient is 2, whereas the remainder is 10. Convert this 10 to hexadecimal as A. So this conversion, that is this dividing, you will do it till you are getting a quotient which is less than 16. So here the 2 is less than 16, so I am stopping here and writing the number starting from the quotient down to top, that is 2A0F. Always remember, for the integer part you need to take down the number from bottom to the top, so it is 2A0F. And for the fractional part, it is written in the right hand side, you have to multiply by 16. So at least 5 decimal points you need to identify. So 5 times I have multiplied. So I have taken the given fractional part, multiply by 16. And if I multiply by 16, I am getting a value as 5.472. Take the integer part alone and record it on the right hand side as 5, and the remaining fractional part, that is 0.472, you just multiply by 16 and record the integer part, and again the remaining fractional you need to keep on multiplying. At least you have to do this multiplication till you are getting 0, otherwise at least 5 times you need to multiply and record the corresponding product on the right hand side. And while writing the equivalent hexadecimal number, you need to take the data starting from top to the bottom, that is from MSD to LSD. So it is 5, 7, 8, D and 4. So together you can represent the hexadecimal value as 2A0F.578D4 with base 16. So it is similar to converting from decimal to binary, whereas there you will be dividing by 2 and for the fractional part you will be multiplying by 2, whereas here you have to divide by 16 and multiply by 16. In the same way you can do it for the octal also, whereas for the octal number, that is decimal to octal conversion, you have to divide by 8 and for the fractional part you have to multiply by 8, and the vice versa is the converting from octal to decimal. What you need to do is identify the weightages. For the integer part, it has to be the weightages 8^0, 8^1, 8^2 for the integer part, and whereas for the fractional part, the weightage is 8^-1, 8^-2, 8^-3. Whereas for the fractional part, as I told, you have to start from the right hand side, then you have to proceed towards the left hand side. So finally, the relationship is hexadecimal numbers, we know it is 0 to F, decimal it is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 15, and for the octal it is 0 to 7, it is the same. 8 you need to represent as 10, 9 it is 11, 10 it is 12. I think if you divide by 8, you will be getting this equivalent octal number. And for the binary, here I have represented in the form of 4 digits. So any decimal number you can represent in terms of binary in the form of 4 digits as 000, and for 1 it is 001, 2 it is 0010, for 3 it is 011, and it is the same up to 15. For 15 the corresponding binary number is 1111. So next set of conversion is converting from octal to binary. So any octal number you take, how to convert directly to binary? So what you can do is, you have to see, take the whole given octal number, leave some spacing and write the corresponding 3-digit binary number. For example, 35, 5 I have written in terms of binary with 3 places, 3 digits, and for 3 it is 001, and for the fractional part again you represent the corresponding binary number for the fractional part too. For 3 it is again 011, for 4 it is 100, for 6 it is 110 along with the binary point. So the equivalent octal, whatever the given octal number, the equivalent binary number is 001101.011100110. So you need to write it continuously. So this is the binary equivalent number for the given octal number. So that is nothing but group it in the form of 3 bits, and together you need to represent the binary number. So this is the vice versa, that is the reverse what we are seeing just now, converting from binary to octal. So for this, take the given binary number and group it as 3 bits and write the corresponding octal number. So for example, start from the LSB for the integer part. So it is group it as 3, 0, 1, 1, the corresponding digit is in octal it is 3, and for 110 it is 6. And similarly for the fractional part, start from the right hand side, in group it as 3 bits. So it is 101. The corresponding octal number is 5, and for the remaining fractional part it is only 1. So as you need to convert to octal, you want it to be represented as 3 digits, so add 2 extra zeros and you'll be getting as 100. For this, the corresponding octal number is 4. So finally, the octal converted value is 63.54. So the next conversion is hexadecimal to octal conversion. So whatever the given hexadecimal number, how to convert directly to octal? So this can be done. First, you need to write the given number with spacing 4.BF85. Write the given number, then represent each of the hexadecimal number with a binary equivalent of size 4. So 4 I have represented as 0100, and for B it is 10011, and for the F it is 4 ones, and for 8 it is 1000, and for 5 it is 0101. That is, each of the hexadecimal number you need to code it as binary equivalent with 4 digits. So later what you need to do is you have to group it as 3 bits and write the corresponding octal equivalent for that grouped data. So the binary equivalent is 0100, group it as 3 bits starting from the LSB, so it is 100, the equivalent octal is 4, and the remaining 0, it is 0, you can leave it. Whereas for the fractional part, start from the MSB, the first group it is 101, so equivalent octal number is 5. The next 3 values are, next group it is 111, the equivalent number is 7. Again it is 111, the equivalent octal number is 7. Then it is 000, the equivalent octal digit is 0. Then 010, the equivalent octal value is 2. And finally it is 1. Whereas you need to group it as 3 bits, add extra 2 zeros, so you'll be getting us 100. So the octal equivalent is of 100 is 4. So finally you can represent the octal equivalent for the given hexadecimal together as 4.577024 with base 8. Even the vice versa also, it is the same. So whatever the given number, represent in terms of, code it in terms of 3 bits, then again group it in the form of 4 bits, and for the, write the equivalent hexadecimal for the 4 bits, whatever the grouping you have done, so you'll be getting the final hexadecimal number. So this is the basic conversions between hexadecimal to octal, octal to hexadecimal, and binary to octal.